Okay, example one. Okay, you want to find the area between the function fx and x axis. So now we have example A, a graph. Okay, function negative x square plus 4x plus 3. Okay, to find the area, we know that this is area above the x axis. So to find this, okay, the limit is from 1 to 3. Okay, for the function negative x square plus 4x plus 3 dx. Okay, and then we integrate the function, we get here negative x cube over 3 plus 4x square over 2 plus 3x. And then we have to substitute the limit from 1 to 3. Okay, before that, we can simplify. Okay, the function we get here 2x square plus 3x. And substitute the value from 1 to 3. Negative 3 cube over 3 plus 2. Okay, minus negative 3. Okay, this one, when we press calculator, we get the value. Okay, the first value is 18 minus 1 over 3 plus the value, okay, 14 over 3. Okay, when you press this one, 18 minus 14 over 3, we get here 13.33 unit square. Okay, because of we now delimited area, so we have to put unit square, alright. Okay, this is what how we find the area between function fx and the x axis. Okay, this is the calculation for the area 1. Okay, I just simplify this. Okay, you can just calculate by yourself. Where the area 1 from the limit 1 to 3, we get 35 unit. Okay, you get 35. Okay. And then for the second area from 3 to 5, okay, we get the area of 12 unit. So, okay, to simplify this, the total area A1 plus A2, we get 35 plus 12, we get 37 unit. Alright, so you can refer later in the PDF file that we'll share in the Telegram group. Okay, so this is the answer for example 3, okay, area between function and x-axis, where the interval is given, okay, from 1 to 5. Okay, for example B, we can see that the graph now is below the x-axis, right? So to find, okay, to find the area, okay, we have to put negative in front of the sign. Okay, now the limit is from 2 to 4 for the function x square minus 6x plus 8 dx. Okay, now we integrate, we get, okay, don't forget negative. Okay, integrate, we get x cube over 3 minus 6 square over 2 plus 8x. Okay, from 2 to 4. Okay, now we simplify first the function. Okay, now we put into integral sign, integral. Okay, this is the step where I substitute, okay, madam substitute the value of 4, okay, minus, and the function that already substitute the value 2. Okay, so when we press calculator, we get the values negative 16 over 3 minus negative 38 over 3. Okay, calculate this, 22 over 3 or 7.33 unit square. Okay, okay, this is how we find, okay, the area below the x-axis. Okay, this is example 2. Okay, we want to find the area between two functions. Okay, for the function fx, negative x square plus 2x plus 3, and then another one, gx x square minus 2x minus 3. Okay, the area you want to find. Okay, this is you want to find the area inside between okay fun be, between the function f and g. So now remember what we learned in case 4, where to find the area. Okay, you have to okay write the limit. Okay, now the limit is from negative 1 here to 3. Okay, for the function we have to function above the area minus function below the area, meaning that f minus g dx. Okay, now okay, for the function fx we have negative x plus 2x plus 3, okay, minus g we have x squared minus 2x minus 3 dx. Okay, we simplify this first. Okay, negative x minus x squared plus 2x plus 3 dx. Okay, negative x minus x, we get here negative 2x. 2x plus 2x, we get 4x plus 6 dx. Right? Always positive. Okay, in front of the integral sign. Okay, now we solve this one. Okay, we get the value negative 2x cubed over 3 plus 4x squared over 2 plus 6x. Okay, substitute the value from negative 1 to 3. Okay, this is the value where madam already substitute the value 3, okay, into the function here, and negative 1. When I press the calculator, we get 18 for the first one and negative 10 over 3. And now to solve this, we get, okay, you can just recheck my the calculation. I might be sometimes miscalculate. So the value now is 21.33. Oops. Unit square. Alright, so I hope you understand. Okay, this is for the example 2, the area between two functions. Okay, example 3, the area between function and x-axis. So now for A, find the area under the graph of fx equal to negative x multiply x minus 3 square from x equal to 1 to x equal to 5. Okay, for this one, a bit different from the previous example where we are not given the graph. So you have to sketch by yourself, by your own. Okay, there are few steps involved. Where the first one, okay, first step you have to find, okay, find the x-intercept. Okay, so now we know that to find y x-intercept, you have to know that this is where the value when y equal to 0. Okay, so now we have a function, this one. Okay, x, negative x equal to 0 because of we know that fx is also y. Okay, so okay, solve this, we get negative x equal to 0, therefore x equal to 0. And then another one, okay, we have x minus 3 square, so we can just open the brackets. We get here x equal to 3 negative 3, x minus 3 equal to 0 and x equal to 3, where the value that we get now, x intercept, is the value where we know that, okay, this is 0.0 and 3, meaning that the graph will pass through the x-intercept. So now we want to find, okay, either the x the graph is now above the x-axis or below the x-axis, we have to proceed with the second step. Okay. Where we have to construct a table. Three intervals. Okay, in the number line. Okay, the first interval is from here. We have negative infinity to zero. Okay, the second interval is from 0 to 3, and the last one is 3 to positive infinity. Okay, we have to take any test point in between the interval. So now I just choose negative 1. This one I choose 1. Okay, this one x. Okay, between 3 to infinity, so I don't choose 4. Okay, now we substitute the value into the function. Okay. Okay, when you substitute, you just press your calculator and get the value. So we know that this one, when we substitute negative 1 into this function, we get, you can just check, positive value. This one I get negative, and the last one is negative. So we know that when we get the positive value, it gives us the information that now the graph is lies above the x-axis. When negative, the graph is below the x-axis, and negative also we get the graph is below the x-axis. Alright? So I hope you understand this part. Okay, never mind. I'll just just write the notes for this one. This is above the x-axis. This one below. And this one also below the x-axis. Alright, so now we back to the graph that we... Okay, from the second part where we construct the table, from the table we back to the number line that we have just now. From the interval negative infinity to zero, okay, this one, negative infinity to zero, the graph is above the x-axis. We just estimate it here. Okay, never mind. The pattern is just, we just sketch. Okay, the important thing we have to know that the graph is now above the x-axis because of we get positive. And then we get the value negative from interval 0 to 3, right? So we estimate the point just like this. Okay, why? Because of this is the x-intercept, meaning that the graph will pass through the point of 0 and 3. And next interval we have 3 to infinity, where the graph is also below the x-axis. So we just continue like this. Alright? Okay, this is the pattern. Okay, for the function, negative x multiply x minus 3 square. So now, where is the area they want to find? We have to get back in the question. Okay, the area they want to find is from x equal to 1. X equal to 1 and from 1 to 5. Alright? So we know that the area, we estimate, this is 1 and this is might 5. Okay, we just estimate. Okay, this is the first area and this is the second area. Okay, meaning that you have to, the total is A1 plus the area 2. We have the third step, you have to construct the integral form for this area. Okay, remember we have two area, so area 1 is between 1 to 3. Okay, now because of we have below the x-axis, we have to put negative sign. Okay, negative for the function negative x dx. Okay, this is for the area 1. And for the area 2, Now, the limit is from 3 to 5. Also, we have negative sign in front because of this is below the x-axis for the function negative x. Okay, you have to solve one by one and then you just add the value area 1 and area 2. Okay, this is the calculation for the area 1. Okay, I just simplify this. Okay, you can just calculate by yourself. Where the area 1 from the limit 1 to 3, we get 35 unit. Okay. You get 35. Okay. And then for the second area, from 3 to 5, okay, we get the area of 12 unit. So, okay. To simplify this, the total area A1 plus A2, we get 35 plus 12, we get 37 unit. Alright, so you can refer later in the PDF file that we'll share in the Telegram group. Okay, so this is the answer for example 3. Okay, area between function and x-axis, where the interval is given, okay, from 1 to 5. Okay, this is example 4, area between two functions. Okay, the question is find the area enclosed between fx equal to negative x square plus 4x and gx equal to 2x minus 3. Okay, here we have few steps. Okay, and the first one is find the intersection points. Okay, to find the intersection points, you have to, okay, this one, the formula fx equal to gx, you have to write like this. Where when we solve this, we get the value, okay, the intersection points we have x equal to 1 and then x equal to 3. Second step, we have to sketch the graph. Okay, we know that now we have two functions. Okay, this one we just estimate, okay? No need the accurate graph. Okay, we just want to know which function lies above the area they want to find. Okay? Okay, this one, this is the area between two functions. Okay, so now to find the area, you have to draw a table. Okay, the third step. Okay, you have to sketch the table to, not sketch, to construct the table. Where the first one is, okay, interval. Okay, interval column, and then test point. And then we have two different function. Okay, okay, TP is test point, and then this is function for fx. Okay, this is function for gx. Okay, now interval that we have, okay, remember, okay, the interval, okay, now the intersection is negative 1 and 3. Okay, negative 1 and 3 here. So this is not important. Okay, it is not important for us to find the area, this one and this one. Okay, the area now is enclosed between two function. Okay, this is the open area. Okay, no need to find. Therefore, for the intervals, okay, we just take from negative 1 to 3 only. Okay, the test point, we can just take, maybe we can just choose a point of 0, okay, because of easy for us to find later for function f. Substitute 0 into f. Okay, f just now we have here negative x plus 4x, negative x squared plus 4x and gx 2x minus 3. Substitute 0 into negative x squared plus 4x, we get this one 0, right? Okay, and gx, we substitute the value of 0, we get negative 3, meaning that now f is greater than g. Okay, so therefore from this information we know that, okay, f lies above the area they want to find, and this one is g. Next, you have to construct. Okay, this is the third step, right? Okay, Okay, next step you have to construct the integral, okay, where we know that this is from negative 1 to 3, okay, for the function f minus g dx. Okay, now we solve this, we get, okay, our function f is negative x square plus 4x minus g, we have here, okay, put in bracket, 2x minus 3 dx. Okay, solve this, we get negative dx, negative x square plus 2x plus 3. Then negative x here. Okay, now you can just press calculator, you get the value of, okay, when okay, when madam press the calculator, we get the value 27 minus 5 over 3. So the answer now is 28.67 unit. Okay, so I hope you understand the example. Example 4, area between two functions. Okay, this is the example 5. Okay, the question is find the area of the region bounded by, okay, the function fx equal to x square plus 3 and gx equal to 1 from x equal to 1 to x equal to 3. Meaning that this one we have two functions. Okay, and different from the previous example, we have the interval from x equal to 1 to x equal to 3. Okay, first step, you have to find the intersection point, so meaning that fx equal to gx. Okay, when we solve this, we get okay, the final answer, x square equal to negative 2. Okay, you can just observe, okay, for the previous step. So we have here, when we cannot square the negative value, therefore we this is impossible, therefore we can just conclude that no intersection point, okay, for the function. So okay, this is the second step where you have to sketch the graph. Okay, to sketch the graph, okay, I just show to you one by one. Okay, the graph will be like this. Okay, no intersection between these two functions. So, to know which one lies above and which one is at the bottom, alright? So, we can proceed the third step where we construct table, okay, from the interval. Now, negative infinity to infinity because of no intersection. And medium choose x equal to 0 as the test point and substitute into the function of fx and gx. We get, when we substitute 0 into fx, we get 3. 0 substitute into g, we get 1. Therefore, we can conclude that, okay, the point g is higher than 1. Therefore, f is greater than g. Okay. So, this is f and this is g. Okay. In the same graph, f lies above the g, okay, function. So the fourth step, you have to shade the area. So now interval is given from point 1 to 3, okay. So the interval, okay, we just, okay, estimate the point 1 and 3, and then you have to shade the area, okay, between the interval 1 and 3. Okay, therefore, this is the area that you have to find. Okay, and the last step, okay, you shade the area, and then the last step, you construct the integral sign from 1 to 3 for the function f minus g dx. Okay, so you can just substitute, simplify, and then we get here x square plus 2, and we integrate, we substitute the value 3 and 1, we get the value 12.67 unit. Okay, this is the example where we do not have the intersection point between two functions, and the interval is given. Okay. Alright, so I hope you understand. This is example 5. Okay, this is example 6. Okay, our last example. Find the area between fx equal to negative x squared and gx equal to negative x cubed from x equal to 0 to x equal to 2. Okay, so now first step, we find the intersection point, okay, between these two functions. So fx equal to gx, okay, fx equal to gx, so we have here negative x squared equal to negative x cubed. So we bring okay, this one negative, x cubed to the left side, we get positive equal to 0, and then we factorize, we take out x squared, so inside the bracket, so we have here negative x, sorry, negative 1 plus x to 0, therefore okay, x equal to 0. And then this one, okay, x equal to 1. Okay, from here we know that our graph, you can just sketch like this. Okay, so the intersection point here is now 0, and then this one we have 1. So it start from negative infinity to 0, 0 to 1, and the last one 1 to infinity. Okay, so we just choose the test point in between, so we now have negative 1. Okay, let's say this is point from, okay, in between 0 to 1 we choose 0.5, and this one we choose 1. Substitute, okay, f negative 1 into the function of f, so we get here negative 1. Okay, you can just test. Okay, press your calculator, and when put negative 0.5, we get here negative 1.4, and f 2 negative 4. For gx, we substitute negative 1, we get 1. G 0.5, we get here negative 1/8. When G 2, sorry, not 2, this is 1, right? Oops, sorry. Okay, now for the last point is 2, okay, not 1. So, x equal to 2, we substitute f 2, we get negative 4. G 2, we get negative 8. Therefore, for the conclusion, we know that, okay, for the interval negative infinity to 0, G is greater than F. And then, for the interval 0 to 1, okay, G is greater than, also greater than F. And the last one is F is greater than G. Now, we can just locate the position for G and F for the interval negative infinity to 0. Okay, so now this is G, this is F, and then for this interval 0 to 1, G, F, and the last one from 1 to infinity, so this is F and this is G. So we know, okay, to conclude that this one for Fx, and this one 9 for gx. Okay, so now you have to find the area from 0 to 1, from, sorry, 0 to 2. So here inside this one, in between, we have the area from 0 to 1, and then another one we have here. Okay, we just estimate this one 2. So you have to find another area. Okay, this one. Okay, the calculation. Okay, the last one. Okay, the step, you construct the table, and then we already shape the region. The last one, we set up the integral. So now we have area A and also area B. Okay, I'll show to you the fourth step, okay, where we find the area of A. Okay, area of A, we get here 1 over 12, okay, where the limit is from 0 to 1, okay, from the intersection 0 to 1, function g minus f, okay, and then we get here, after we calculate, we get 1 over 12 unit. And then for the area B, the limit is from 1 to 2 here, okay. And for the function, we can see that f is over g, okay? So f minus g, dx. So we get the area for B is 1.42. Therefore, the total area is 1 over 12 plus 1.42. We get the total area 1.50 unit. Okay, this is how we find the area for the between two function f and g. And also there'll be one more condition in between, okay, the interval 0 to 2. Okay, the you can see the figure in second step. Alright, so I hope you understand this. Okay, thanks all.